Herzlich willkommen beim Campus Sport.
Hello and welcome to Campus Sport. My name is Patricia Kummer. I'm an Olympic and a University champion in snowboarding. Yes, the Swiss snowboard star tells her story. We review the Winter Universiade. The university fencing champion who became the IOC president, plus the Summer Universiade in review. Mikko Greiss, the biathlete champion turned student. And a look ahead to the University Worlds of 2016. We start Campus Sport with Patricia Kummer of Switzerland, the snowboarding star of the parallel giant slalom. Now, Patricia is not only successful on the board, she's also a psychology student at the Institute of Psychology in Bern. The current Olympic and Universiade champion is a model for student athletes. To combine studying with life as a top athlete is not so much a chore for Patricia, it's more a way of life. I simply realized that only doing sport isn't enough for me. It means I need another activity for my brain. So when I'm studying, my life is different. It's a different dimension compared to sport, and that is exciting. You can discover so many things about this world, but also about the psyche of a human being, to see how we humans work on the biological and neurological side. That is so interesting. I'm somebody who works hard, and I don't worry about whether it's too much to do or not. When I decide to do something, I go for it, and I never give up. Patricia began her psychology studies in 2009 and finished her bachelor's degree at Fern Uni Online 6 months before the Olympics in Sochi. Now she's taking her master's degree in development psychology. I can simply say that Ms. Kummer is well prepared for the seminar every time, and she also actively takes part in all the discussions. Patricia's been looking into cognition, learning, and memory. She has an exam to take just a few weeks before her World Cup opener. I'm expecting Ms. Kummer to present a paper on a subject that I've given to her and to explain it, and then, based on what she's presented, we can compare various analyses on different groups of children with different disorders. It's an empirical analysis, which is a very demanding examination because it's an original work. And to succeed, you have to work through the difficult parts. So in front of other students who ignore the fact that she's an Olympic champion, Patricia is examined on coordination disorders of children. And despite a tight schedule, she's satisfied with her work. I prepared myself as well as possible, and what was great was no one, except my professor and I, had read the initial work. So I think I've done pretty well, it was good. She gets no special treatment, she's simply one student among many. I don't like to go to professors and say, hello, I'm an Olympic champion, I need this and that. I'm not like that. It's not my style. But I am studying less intensely compared to other people. It means I need more time than other students do. For her master's, the snowboarding star chose neuropsychology and development psychology. She wanted to look at the relationship between motor skills and cognitive skills. I've looked at so many interesting subjects where it would be really fascinating to do more research. But at this stage, I can't say where I'll be in 3 or 4 years' time, whether or not I will continue in sport, for example. I'm not planning that far ahead. Patricia has to be efficient in her time management. While she's studying, she can't completely neglect her sport. She still needs to train for the World Cup season for snowboarding a passion she discovered when she was a kid. I never thought I wanted to become Olympic champion or world champion or win medals. Rather, I just wanted to snowboard.
Meisterin oder irgendwelche Medaillen gewinnen möchte, sondern ich habe einfach immer nur snowboarden wollen. Ich liebe die Geschwindigkeit.
I love speed. I'm a kind of speed junkie. It's my passion. That's why it works so well. During her career, she's won 10 World Cup races. She was a Crystal Globe winner in 2013 and 2014. She has a World Championship bronze and silver. And 2 years ago, she was hoping for gold at the Winter Universiade in Trentino. It was a very difficult race, too much fog. Even though they made a lot of effort to make a perfect track, it was almost impossible. Kummer finished just outside the medals. But despite a disappointing result in Trentino, she learned to cope with situations in a way that would go on to help her to the Olympic title in Sochi in 2014. I couldn't believe it when I crossed the finish line. I felt empty. I didn't know what to think. But then when the flag was raised, I'm not normally so emotional, but at that moment, I nearly cried.
Und ich bin auch nicht nah am Wasser gebaut, aber es hat sogar mir die Tränen in die Augen gedrückt.
And so the Olympic champion traveled to Granada for her third Winter University Games, full of ambition. I knew it was my last chance to get that title. It would be the last time that I could take part in that competition. I knew I wanted to win. This was the final of the parallel giant slalom. Her opponent, Germany's Selina Jürg. But Patrizia was simply too strong for her, and she finally became Universiade champion. In the Spanish Sierra Nevada, Patrizia Kummer achieved her goal. If you really trust in something and you like it, you enjoy it, and you really want to achieve it, then you can succeed. The Swiss champion is well aware of her status as a role model. She's become involved in social action and protection of the environment. Altogether, an impressive personality on and off the snowboard. Now the campus sport review of the 27th Winter Universiade. The cross-country skiing and ski jumping were held at Strebka Plesso in Slovakia. And for the first time in FISU history, there was a ski jumping team competition for women. Team Russia won it. They had Irina Avakumova, a highly ranked World Cup athlete, and already the winner of the individual competition here. I was able to win this competition due to the high quality of my training, and also my experience played a role. It's not the first time I've taken part in important competitions. The Russian delegation dominated the whole Winter Universiade, especially in cross-country. Altogether, they won 56 medals, 20 gold, 18 silver, and 18 bronze. Partly because Russia has invested heavily in university sports.
Universiade, especially, is a very good chance for young athletes as a reserve for national team. Come here to demonstrate their potentials and be in the future, present the country on the top level event like Olympic Games and World Championships.
With 7 gold medals of the 7 team medals in 9 cross-country competitions, Russian athletes were almost unbeatable. Andrei Larkov took 3 titles in the sprint, the mass start, and the relay. The defending champion in the Nordic combined was Adam Cisla from Poland, the physical education student from the University of Warsaw. He'd won 2 titles in Trentino. Now he doubted himself before these games, but once again he walked away with 2 golds and a lot of confidence in his future. I'm really happy to be World University Champion for the 2nd time. I'm really satisfied that I could make it once again. The biathlon took place at Ozrybli, and much was expected from the local star, Paulina Fialkova. she'd taken part in the Sochi Olympics. Fialkova's a student of Matei Bell University in Banska Bystrica. And she didn't disappoint the fans here. She got the gold in the 7.5-kilometer sprint, bronze in the 15-kilometer individual, and silver in the 10-kilometer pursuit. The second part of the Winter Universiade was held in southern Spain, some 1,200 athletes from 41 nations taking part. On a difficult track in the Sierra Nevada mountains, the men's Super-G was won by Michelangelo Tentori of Italy, just 1/100th of a second ahead of Marc Oliveras from Andorra. 6 days later, Tentori got another gold, this time in the giant slalom, beating his teammate Rocco Del Sante. The most successful female skier was the Norwegian Christina Fausa Osberg. With the victory in the Super-G and the giant slalom, Christina was more than satisfied.
I did some great races back home in Norway before this, and I came here with a lot of confidence. I hope that I can make more great results and ski up to my potential.
Among the top figure skaters at the Games, Germany's Peter Liebers. He'd finished eighth at the Olympics in Sochi. Now at the Universiade Igloo in Granada, he overcame a shoulder injury and skated his Olympic program to become Universiade champion. In ice hockey, Russia and Canada battled for the women's gold with a final score 3-0, the Russians taking the title. Japan took the bronze, beating China 4-1. And the games ended with the men's ice hockey final, the Russian team defeating Kazakhstan 3-1. It was Russia's sixth Universiade triumph in a row. Altogether at the games, Russia dominated the medal table ahead of South Korea and Kazakhstan. For the first time, the Winter University Games have been held in two different countries, Slovakia and Spain, representing 540 universities. The next edition in 2017 will be held in the city of Almaty in Kazakhstan. Still to come, the university memories of the IOC president, a review of the Summer Universiade in Gwangju, the Olympic biathlon champion, Mikko Grice, on his student experiences, and a look ahead to the action in 2016.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
Lausanne in November, and the opening day of the General Assembly of FISU, where the IOC president, Thomas Bach, was one of the speakers. He recalled the days when he'd taken part in the World University Games, in Moscow in 1973, and in Mexico in 1979.
It was an important step in the community building and to learn even more what it means to live in a village where you have all the nations together. In the Olympic Games as an athlete, I had this privilege only once. And so it was a great experience to have these two other experiences there during the Universiade. And in this respect, it was really very important.
Bach had first been pushed into fencing by his parents, age 5. At 22, he was a member of the German foil team that took gold at the 1976 Olympics. And the following year, he won the individual gold at the World Championships. But it was the University Games that had been the launch pad.
This was a wonderful experience at the time. There in Moscow in 1973, in the middle of the Cold War, where not everybody could travel to Soviet Union at the time. to live there in the Lomonosov University together with all these athletes, and trying to learn also about the Moscovites, to learn about the Russians, to get in contact, was a great experience from which I learned a lot.
Elected as the 9th IOC president in September 2013, Thomas Bach is a prime example of successfully pursuing academic studies and sport in harness. He was a student of law and politics at the University of Würzburg.
It was actually not so difficult because in law you have not to be at university every day. You can manage pretty well. This is pretty much different for people who are studying medicine or other courses. So it went pretty well. I did in the first part of my university time, I did more sport. And then at the very end, I was concentrating for some time more on the studies. So there I was pretty lucky to be able to combine the two.
He was elected as an IOC member at the age of 37, and he's played a series of influential roles in the organization ever since, finally becoming the most powerful political figure in world sport, president of the International Olympic Committee. So how did it happen? What do you need to become a top leader?
It is not, becoming a top leader. I think there for student athletes, what is important is in their studies and in sport to be authentic, to find out what you enjoy most, what is the best for you, and then to be authentic in all what you are doing. And as athletes, they know very well the recipe for success, that you have to work hard, that you have to work hard every day, that you have to respect others, and that you have to set yourself ambitious goals, and then to work to make this dream coming true one day.
The IOC president is convinced that in today's society, values of excellence, friendship, and respect are more important than ever. And those values provide a strong link between the IOC and FISU. Thank you. The 28th Summer Universiade at Gwangju took place in July with competitions in 21 sports. In archery, the double Olympic champion and world number one, Ki Bo Bay, not only broke the world's best mark, she also won three Universiade titles on home soil. The Republic of Korea was in fact the top nation with a total of 108 medals, ahead of Russia and China. Victoria Ziabkina of Kazakhstan took the 100 meters in 11.23 seconds. Then she added the 200 meter title, becoming the first woman since 1987 to achieve the sprint double at the World University Games. The 22-year-old from Almaty would go on to get a third gold in the 4x100. A third Universiade title in a row for Paweł Fajdek from Poland in the hammer throw. With his final throw of 80.05 meters, he beat the Belarusian duo, Pavel Beresha and Sergei Kalamoiche. Fajdek's decisive win came after a scare with two early no-throws. The most successful swimmer of Gwangju, the American, Shannon Vreeland. She took four gold medals in the 100 and the 200 freestyle and two relays, plus a bronze. In the pool, Team USA grabbed 14 gold medals. He'd won two silvers in 2013. Now the German gymnast, Fabian Hambüchen, finished his university career with a gold medal in artistic gymnastics.
It's been my last Universiade, so I'm kind of sad because I will definitely miss that atmosphere here, and just happy about that medal, and it was a great day.
Gold on the bar for Hambüchen. In fencing, the French team piled up the gold medals, winning eight of the 12 Universiade titles. And whether it was the saber, the épée, or the foil, men or women, the French were always on the podium. In football, Italy became the champions, defeating the Koreans in front of their home crowd. 3-0 the score, Japan took the bronze. And France would take the women's title, silver would go to Russia, bronze to Argentina. A dramatic final in men's basketball, the Jayhawks, an American college team, finally overcoming Germany after two extra times. The Americans would go on to take the women's gold medal too, beating Canada. And that was the summer edition of the World University Games of 2015. The next edition will be staged in Chinese Taipei in 2017. Coming next on Campus Sport, Miko Grice, the 3-times biathlon Olympic champion who went back to life as a student. And a preview of the World University Championships of 2016 with its director, Paulo Ferreira. This is Miko Grice, the German biathlete who dominated the Olympics in 2006. He's not.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
A star of his sport, but a student once again, seeking qualifications to avoid an uncertain professional future. At the age of 39, his sights are now set on Ansbach University of Applied Sciences. I tried to study at the beginning of my sports career, but I realized pretty quickly that I wasn't able to combine both, so I decided to focus only on my sports career. And what a career it was, with those 2006 Olympics the high point. But 6 years later, in the season's opening World Cup event in Östersund, he finished down in 67th place and decided to retire. Miko Grice had lost the will to win. When I realized in the summer of 2012 that my sports career would no longer last a long time, I chose to study once again. This time it was international management at Ansbach. I'm getting towards the end of my studies now, but that was the right decision then to take up studying once again, no doubt.
Ja, war auf alle Fälle die richtige Entscheidung.
Founded in 1996, Ansbach is a modern university in the center of southern Germany. Miko Grice is one of the 30 former or present top-level sportsmen studying online. Normally, I'm technically orientated, but in sports, international management can be used in a better way. And sport is my passion. So is technical science. But you can't start studying mechanical engineering or electrical engineering at the age of 40. It's too late. But with business management, well, I can use that everywhere. It's something I can use all the time. But I really want to know where my studies are going to lead me. As a biathlete, Grice won 3 world golds and the overall World Cup title in 2007 with 21 World Cup victories along the way. All useful experience for what was to come. I really think that I've learned through sport to have powers of endurance, for example, for my correspondence course. It meant choosing the course modules, organizing them, and passing the exams. And that's really a question of how to set your goals and how to reach them. My marks have been pretty good, but now I really am focusing on my studies. But what kind of student is Miko Grice? How can he define himself as a student? That's a good question. I'm hardworking, definitely, and I'm engaged in the subject. Mikkel Greiss has never taken part in a winter Universiade. The maximum age is 28, and by the time he reached the top of biathlon, he was no longer a student. That remains something of a regret. I think a Universiade is a really great competition. It's great experience because for most of the athletes, it's the first time that they take part in a big event. And besides the sport, of course, they can also meet people at the events, have conversations, discussions. And I think all those aspects around the competition not only make for a very good sports experience, but also a great personal and important human experience. Mikkel Greiss of Germany, demonstrating that even after a long, successful sports career, an athlete can have a future without sport by putting in the effort in academic study. The World University Championships are part of FISU's sporting fabric. Alternating with the summer and winter Universiades, they're organized every even-numbered year. In 2016, 8,000 students will compete in 34 different sports.
We will start up 3 new sports. We will have the sport climbing, we will have the sambo, and we will also have the ski orienteering. We know that universities exist all over the world, and we feel the responsibility to take our events. Sometimes they are very developed, but other ones that are smaller, we feel the responsibility to take these events to athletes all over the world, student athletes, of course.
Organized for the first time in 1963, the World University Championships are becoming more and more successful. 2 years ago, FISU ran 28 different championships. Here's Paulo Ferreira again.
These international federations, most of them Olympic federations, see the potential in university sport, and they know about the 170 million students around the world and the 40,000 universities around the world. So, of course, they see the benefit and they see what they can get out of this as well.
In the World Championships of 2016, not only will Olympic athletes be involved, it's also an opportunity for the students to step up towards the elite. And for the organizers, there's the legacy to consider, a key element for FISU.
We want every single event to be the best of that specific sport. So for 2016, I can say that I am fairly comfortable that we will have an exceptional year for World University Championships. There's no doubt about that.
Next March, the World University Championships will take place in speed skating at Baselga di Pine in Italy. And there'll be coverage of it here on Eurosport. And that was Campus Sport.
Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.
The International University Sports Federation brings together millions of students worldwide around the same values, excellence in mind and body. Thousands of students, hundreds of universities participate in FISU events, the rendezvous for the best student athletes. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.